Hi everyone, I'm Flavia and I appreciate you watching this video. Today we will be creating some split gate fold cards with belly bands made out of cardstock. This type of note card is very easy and fun to make. To create the split gate fold note cards, I will use this white heavyweight cardstock that I got from Amazon. This is the type of cardstock that I like to use for the base of my cards as well as for die cutting. The quality is very good and it has a great price point. This brand offers cardstock in 80 pounds and 120 pounds, and I like to have both. Usually I use the 120 pounds for creating the base for my cards and also for die cutting, since it is pretty thick. And I like to use the lighter weight cardstock, the one that is 80 pounds, for when I want to add white panels inside my note card. However, for today, since I will be adding lots of die cuts to the front of this split gate fold note card, I will actually use the 80 pounds cardstock for the base, so the final result is not too bulky. So, using a piece of cardstock that measures 5.5 by 8.5 inches, I will score it at 2 1/8 from each end. Then I will flip it and score on the other side of this cardstock as well. Most of the cardstock that I buy measures 8.5 by 11 inches, so if that's your case, remember that we can make 2 split gate fold cards out of an 8.5 by 11 inches piece of cardstock by simply cutting it in half. Once I have the note cards ready, I can start working on the die cut pieces that I will adhere to the front. Today I'm using this old stamp and die set by Honeybee Stamps. This is the Paradise Bloom set, and I will be stamping and die cutting this large flower and leaf right here on the right. And here is a quick look on the different colors of cardstock that I will be using to stamp these flowers. It is by Recollections, and even though it is not as heavyweight as I prefer for die cutting, I absolutely love these colors and that's why I'm using it. If you're interested, I will have a list of all products used over on my blog, and you can find the list in the description below. To stamp the flowers and leaves, I will use a watermark pad so I can heat emboss them. That means I will have to prep my cardstock first with an anti-static powder. The powder tool that I like to use is by Rabbit Hole. The design of this tool is just like a makeup brush, and I love it because it is easy to store, messy-free, and keeps us from getting anti-static powder all over our fingers. The embossing powder that I chose for today is also one of my favorites. It is a holographic powder by Ranger. I will stamp lots of flowers, and for each panel, I will first prep it with the anti-static powder, then stamp one flower using a watermark pad, and flip the panel so I can stamp it again on the other corner of this piece of cardstock. After that, I will add the embossing powder on both images at once and set it aside. I will keep on repeating this process until I'm done, and only then I will heat set these flowers. This way, I will only have to turn on my heating gun once, and the process will definitely be faster. I usually like to speed up the video like I'm doing here, just to be mindful of your time, but know that this process did take me some time since I stamped so many flowers and I was definitely not moving this fast. I was being very careful as I was stamping so I wouldn't mess it up, which to be honest is very rare when I use my Misty stamping tool. You can stamp these images with a clear block as well, but for me it is safer if I use a stamping tool. Notice how the holographic powder makes the cardstock that is underneath it look darker as we heat set it. It actually gives the impression that we stamped these flowers with a darker color of ink, and we end up with this tone-on-tone result. It is very beautiful in person, and it has a lot of sparkle too. I repeated that same process of stamping and heat embossing for the leaves using a bright green cardstock and that same holographic embossing powder. Now we can move on to the die cutting process. Since I stamped multiple images in one panel, using a pair of scissors, I will cut them apart so I can die cut one flower and one leaf at once. I'm using my Gemini Junior die cutting machine, and I will use a piece of clear tape to hold my metal plate in place as I run it through my die cut machine. Here is a closer look at one of these die cuts so you can see how much sparkle the embossing powder has. Off camera, I die-cut some more flowers. I did not stamp or heat emboss again. I only die-cut it so I can add another piece to the back of my already heat embossed flowers to make it thicker, since the cardstock is not heavyweight. After that's done, I will start adhering these flowers and leaves to the front of my split gatefold note cards. I will start by adhering a flower right in the center. Actually, I will adhere two flowers in the center, so when the card is open, we have one flower on the right and the other one on the left. So for this first flower, I will only add liquid adhesive to the left side in the back and adhere it to the left side of my split gatefold note card. Then I will do the same to the right side. However, to make sure that I perfectly line up these two flowers so when the card is closed, it looks like there is just one in the center, I will open the note card and temporarily tape the next die-cut flower over the one that I just adhered with the back facing up. Then I will add liquid adhesive only to one half of this die cut. Now I can close this note card, and once the liquid adhesive is dry, I can open it again and remove the tape. Once that's done, I can go ahead and add some more flowers and leaves, overlapping them a bit. I will add two more flowers on each side so it looks even when the note card is open and on display. To make it easier to overlap the flowers and leaves, I will only add a small amount of liquid adhesive in the center of the die-cut flowers so I can later tuck in the leaves. Since the leaves are pretty large, I will cut them in half and use both pieces. Once I have all of my flowers and leaves in place, I will go back and add some more liquid adhesive to the die cuts that only have glue in the center so it doesn't become a problem to slide in and out the belly band that we will add in a minute. But before we do that, using a pair of scissors, I will cut out all of the die cut pieces that are sticking out so this note card can go inside an A2 size envelope. Also, using this hot foil plate set by Spellbinders, I created off camera a panel that I will adhere to the inside of this note card. That will be the panel where I will write a message. I chose the largest piece of this set and I use a gold foil. So let's now create a belly band. Here I have a piece of cardstock that is about 1/2 inch wide. I will wrap it around the note card to figure out how long it needs to be and trim off the excess. I will reinforce the fold on both sides of this belly band using a bond folder and use liquid adhesive in the back. When you do this, make sure that the belly band is not too tight. We want it to be easy for the recipient to slide this belly band in and out of the note card. To decorate this belly band, I will add some thin strips of cardstock to the front. I will also add some cardstock strips to the inside of this note card to give it a more finished look. This is definitely an extra step, but I think that it makes all the difference. At the end, I decided to change the color for the belly band and go for a green one instead of orange, so it stands out more. For the sentiment, I die cut the word hello using a die plate by Honeybee Stamps as well. I will actually stack some green die cuts for dimension and top it with the golden die cut hello. I will also add a sentiment strip to the front of this note card. I will place it right in the center so the recipient cannot see it when the belly band is on. It will work as a surprise element for when they remove the belly band. I chose the sentiment "You Amaze Me" from that stamp set with the large flowers that I showed you earlier. If you decide to add belly bands to your note cards, make sure you test the belly band and that it easily slides in and out. Moving on to the next note card, I will use the purple flowers. Starting with the flower in the center, again I will adhere it to the left side only, then open the note card and place the second flower that will also go in the center on top of the one that I just adhered, making sure it is perfectly lined up. Just like with the previous note card, I will temporarily tape this die-cut flower in place and add liquid adhesive to only one side and fold this note card over. Once the liquid adhesive is dry, I will open this note card and remove the tape. Now I can go ahead and add as many flowers and leaves as I want, overlapping them a bit to cover as much of the white cardstock as I can. I will also add a foiled panel inside where I will write my message, as well as cardstock strips to tie everything together. With the note card folded, I will again cut out the die-cut pieces that are sticking out. I decided to go for a purple belly band and present a die cut of the word hugs, also in gold cardstock. So here are all of the finished note cards. To make the envelope match, I stamped on the flap of each envelope using that same flower stamp and dye inks of that same color of each envelope, but slightly darker. The blue one was actually the first note card that I made, and I did not stack die cut flowers for this one. Since the cardstock is lightweight, you can actually see the shape and feel the die-cut leaf that is under each flower. It is not really a big deal, and I don't think most people will notice it, but I did. So that is why I thought it would be a bad idea to adhere another die-cut flower in the back of each head-embossed flower, so the cardstock is thicker and it doesn't show what's underneath. Notice how I can easily slide out each belly band. That is why it is so important not to make them too tight. All of these note cards have the same sentiment strip hidden behind the belly band, and all of these note cards can be kept on display. If you're interested in more information and pictures of these note cards, make sure to visit my blog. I would love to have you there, and you can find the link in the description down below. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing to my channel so you do not miss the next one. Thank you so much for spending this time with me. Have a wonderful day, and I hope to see you again soon.